Hello and welcome to this new tutorial series for Botcha 3D. The aim of this series is to familiarize you with the interface and the concepts of Botcha 3D. At the end of the session, you should be able to perform basic tasks, navigation, loading meshings and drawing on them. And we want also to introduce you to the ability of generating geometry within Botcha. These tutorials will be split in a number of lessons, and in this first lesson we're going to do some introduction for the UI. What you see on screen is what you will see once you have loaded Botcha 3D from Windows. Botcha is available both on Windows and on the Mac OS. The UI of Botcha adapts a concept of contextuality, meaning that depending on the context that you have at the moment, you will be able to do different operations. And you will be presented only with the operations available to that specific object or that specific context, not to overwhelm you with too many buttons or too much UI. On the top bar, we see the contextual bar to the selection. At the moment we don't have any selection, so the text here tells us no selection. We can see also the view bar, where we can zoom on the selected object, we can change the view. We will be able also to set the camera mode into orthographic, and we will be able to toggle the grid if we want, so to show or hide. The other buttons that we have is the ability of taking a screenshot and to render out an image. And this toolbar will change depending on the selection that we make. We will see how in the later tutorials. On the left-hand side, we see a number of commands. These commands are also contextual and will change depending on what you have selected at the moment. The commands that we have now is to import a mesh, to import an image, or to create some geometry. We can find the same command in the Pie menu. I can bring up the Pie menu using the middle mouse click, the mouse wheel click, or Alt and right mouse click on the Mac. It acts exactly as clicking on this toolbar here using the Pie menu. The Pie menu is just a little bit more comfortable, so if you're working on your viewport, you can center click and go to one of the options that you're given. On the right hand side, we see the side panel. As everything in Botcha, also the side panel is contextual. At this moment, we have an empty model with no images, no generators, and we see that the corresponding tabs are empty. But we see the camera properties, and here we can change the focal length, the position, and the target of the camera manually. The viewport, the 3D viewport, it's the main area of focus of Botcha, where you're going to do most of your work. You can navigate through the viewport either by rotation, so by right-clicking on the mouse and dragging, you will be able to rotate the viewport in any direction you want. You can zoom in either by using the mouse wheel or by control and right-click and dragging. You can also shift and right-click, and you will be able to pan. As you can see, the view now is moving and I am panning across the 3D view. If I want to specify a definite viewpoint, I can use the Change View tab here. For example, if I want to see a top view, I can click on top, and here I am, seeing the model from the top. If I want to see it from the front. You can go to front, and I'm going to see it from the front. You can see that here automatically the option ortho is toggled. Orthographic perspective, projection, is the way the camera now acts, meaning that there will be no perspective distortion in the view, and you will see the model that are near as big as the model that are far away. If I go to the change view tab and go to reset, the view is reset to its original position. I can toggle here also the orthographic perspective on and off, and you can see that in the orthographic perspective, the grid, all the small squares that I have in the grid have the same size, because it doesn't matter if they're close or far, they will be visualized with the same size. If we uncheck ortho, we will have perspective projection, so we'll see as the human eye see, and things that are near will be bigger than things that are far away. In this example, you can see that the grid, the square of the grid in this direction, are bigger than the square in here. So we have seen that the UI of Botcha is subdivided into four elements: the top bar with the menu bar and the contextual bar, the command bar that is on the left hand side that has commands that are presented with the current context, which are the same as the pie menu that I can middle mouse click and get it out, and the side panel that presents information about the selection that I have, and the 3D viewport where I can see my model where I am working. These are the main components of the UI of Botcha. Later, we will see how we can start beginning to work.